Now I'll do my homemade products, which is only two, so that shouldn't be anything. I have my vegetable glycerin. It's almost gone. I'm probably gonna do a video on how I make my vegetable glycerin, but got this bottle. It's just vegetable glycerin, water, jojoba oil, and some essential oils. But I'll show you all how I make this probably in my next video, because it's probably gonna be gone by the end of the week. So yeah, got my vegetable glycerin, and then I have my coconut butter. And I made, literally y'all, I made this stuff December of 08, it's now November 09, and it's still a really good amount of stuff that's left. And all it is a 16-ounce container of the African shea butter, the 100% unrefined, melt it down, and then I take like a 14-ounce thing of the coconut oil, the unrefined 100% coconut oil. I don't know why my brain is bad. Anyway, the 100% unrefined coconut oil. And then I just whisk it into the melted shea butter. And then when I made this first time, I put some jojoba oil in it, put some essential oils in it. But I really don't need to do that. Honestly, all I need is shea butter and coconut oil. So next time I make this stuff, I'll probably do a video on it, but it'll be a while, because this stuff is going to last me forever, literally. But yes, yeah, so this is what I call my coconut butter. So it's coconut oil and shea butter mix. And this is I put this in my hair every day. Daily moisturizer. Same with the vegetable glycerin. I spray my hair with this every day. And lastly, I just go through all of the natural products I have. The stuff I don't have, but I use, is Hellmann's mayonnaise with olive oil in it, and an egg for my protein treat. And with that, I use my avocado oil. And again, I have a video on all of them. And lemongrass essential oil. So that's that. Then you all know I do my hot oil treatment and honey hair mask. So I have my olive oil and honey, and this is some really cheap olive oil. I'm not gonna buy this stuff again. I don't think it makes a big difference, but I don't know. This is really cheap extra virgin olive oil, but it's doing its job for now. But I'm not gonna buy it anymore. I was kind of in a crunch when I bought this. So olive oil, honey, extra virgin olive oil. And I have my aloe vera gel, and I put this on my edges every chance I get. I didn't put any once today. I don't know. Whatever. I usually put this stuff on my edges, like, every day, but depends on how my hair is looking, but I'll put it on. And my other two essential oils, peppermint and rosemary, and I put this in my shea butter and my, glycerin concoction. But like I said, next time I make the shea butter and coconut oil mix, I don't think I'll be putting it in the oil. But so this is basically for my vegetable glycerin. This is that. I have my vegetable glycerin, my jojoba oil. You can see how oily. But I only use this for my vegetable glycerin, so I don't know why it's so oily on the outside. But either way. So here's my vegetable glycerin and my jojoba oil, and then my baking soda. And last but not least, the most important natural ingredient for any natural woman or man or natural head in general is water. Water is your friend. It always will be for the rest of your life. Drink it, spray it. Water is the business. So I spray my hair with water whenever it feels, especially now because it's cold. It's, you know, getting colder now, and whenever I have my hair just kind of out and not really in any kind of style or anything. You remember when I had it in a style sometimes? After I come home from being outside, if it's really cold, I'll just spray my hair with some water. Put some moisture back in it, because your hair loses moisture when it's cold outside like that. And if you're like me and you're broke and you can't afford to go to a natural hair salon and get your hair in some kind of protective style, make sure you have some water. Get a spray bottle and some water. I use distilled water. I'm kind of a, I don't know. I use distilled water and drinking water. Like whenever I don't finish my bottle of water and it's just kind of sitting there, I put that water in the water bottle. I don't really use sink water. That's kind of like, I don't know, self-indulgent, but you can use sink water. It's all fine. Oh, it's all the same. But yeah, water is your friend, especially now that it's cold. So, those are all of my products that I use. As far as tools, the only thing I've been using lately is my Demming brush, and I only use that when I shampoo. I only detangle my hair once a week because I don't like putting combs and stuff to my hair at all. And the only reason I started doing it again is because my hair is growing, so it's getting a lot harder to finger comb. So, you know, I'm kind of forced to use some kind of tool to detangle my hair. But that's the only tool I really use most of the time, is the Demming brush. That's once a week. So, that's my product. And if you all want me to talk about a little more about some of the products that I use, or if you use some products and you think I should include them in my itinerary, then let me know. And I will try them. But that's all I have for you all today. So, until the next time, I will see you in the next video. Bye!